Next up, we're going to look at the directives used for conditional compilation. These directives let us include or exclude part of the source code if a certain condition is met. First, we have the if and endif directives, which specifies a section of code that will only be included if the condition after the if directive is true. Note that this condition must evaluate to a constant expression. Just as with the C++ if statement, we can optionally include any number of else if or elif directives and one final else directive. Sometimes we may want to compile a section only if a certain macro has been defined, irrespective of its value. We can then use two special operators, which are defined and not defined. The same effect can also be achieved using the directives if defined and if not defined, respectively. For example, the if defined section is only compiled if the specified macro has been previously defined. Note that the macro is considered defined even if it has not been given a value. Next, we have the error directive, which aborts the compilation when found. This directive can be useful, for example, to determine if a certain line is being compiled or not. The directive can optionally take a parameter that specifies the description of the generated compilation error. Another standard directive is line, which allows us to change the line number that is displayed when an error occurs during compilation. Following this directive, the line number will, as usual, be increased by 1 for each successive line. The directive can also take an optional string parameter that allows us to change the file name that will be shown when an error occurs. The last standard directive is pragma, or pragmatic information. This directive is used to specify options to the compiler. For example, we can use pragma message to have the compiler output a string to the build window, or pragma warning to change how the compiler handles warnings.